Hi guys, and welcome back to the channel. In this one, and this is a quick one, we're going to look at how you can suspend a job for a certain period of time, while in the meantime leaving room for other jobs to be executed. As always, before we get started, if you like the video, give it a thumbs up. It really does mean a lot. And in one of the corners, there's a little red button where you can subscribe to my channel and also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified when I put out new videos. I do that once or twice a week. But let's just get to it. So we're going directly into Studio today, and the first thing I want to do is go into Manage Packages. And here in the official feed, I will search for Persistence, the UiPath Persistence Activities Package. I will install and save, and then we'll just have to wait for that to actually be installed. And that will just take a second. There we go. And as always, when working with persistence activities, we want to go to the project tab and the project settings. And then we want to make sure that this supports persistence option is enabled and click OK. And now if we go to the activities pane, if we collapse these guys, and I have enabled that I group the activities by package, so I can see all the activities that are in this UiPath persistence activities package. And the one I'm interested in inside of this long running group is this one called Resume After Delay. And I found this by coincidence when I was making my Action Center videos just a couple of days ago, but we'll drag that into our workflow. And what we'll then need to do is we'll set our resume time, because when we reach this point, the job is going to go into a suspended state just as when we were working with Action Center. And that will leave room for other jobs to be executed while this job is in the suspended state. So the resume time, we are going to, I'll just open the advanced editor here. We'll just add 30 seconds from the time that we reach this point. So I'll just use the now.addSeconds and then add 30 as the parameter as the resume time and click save. And if I run the job now, what's going to happen is when it reaches this point, it'll go into that suspended state. And let's try and do that. And we can see the job starts, immediately goes into a suspended state. And we can see that by this resume button being visible. And also it says here that execution has been suspended and is waiting for external events to complete. Well, the external event in this case is not an external event. It is just waiting for time to pass. So if I click the resume button now, it's going to go back to the suspended state because the 30 seconds haven't passed yet. But now after just a short break, as you saw, the 30 seconds should have passed. So if I click the resume button now, the job runs to completion. So how does this look if we deploy a package to Orchestrator? First of all, let me change the add seconds to just 10 seconds or 5 seconds because we don't want to wait for too long. Then I'm going to publish the package. And once the package has been successfully published, we'll jump to Orchestrator. And we can see here in my shared folder, we don't have any processes yet. So I'll add a new process. I'll select a package that'll be the suspend package that I just published. Click next, next, and create, and close. So now we've built this process that will suspend itself for 5 seconds and then resume automatically. So let me just zoom out a little bit before we run this. So we can see this virtual machine I have in the background. This is where the unattended process will actually be executed. So I'll just start it up. And we should see it sign in to the machine. And now the process is in a running state. Fairly soon it should switch to being suspended. There we go, it goes into the suspended state. And then once the robot, so to speak, has signed out of the virtual machine, within a few seconds, we should see the state change from suspended to running again, because now the 5 seconds have passed. So we'll wait for that to happen now. It can sometimes take a little bit longer. And there we go, it goes back into the running state, signs into the machine, and runs the process to completion. And we're done. All right, so that was just a very quick look at how you can suspend a job using the persistence activities. I hope you found it useful. If you did, give it a thumbs up and watch one of these videos, subscribe and all of that. And then I hope to see you in the next one. Until then, take care.